Today we are with Mr. Howard Prime, who is the country manager for Thailand for Simpson Marine. Good morning to you, Howard.
Hi, how are you doing?
I'm very well, thank you. Now, here we are at the 8th Pattaya, Ocean Marina Pattaya Boat Show.
That's correct.
How has the show gone for you so far?
It's been really quite good so far, actually. We were expecting to have reduced numbers on 2018. And in fact, the footfall is slightly down so far. However, the sort of client that we have seen looking at all of our boats has been quite serious, and from that point of view, we're quite pleased with what's been going on. And it's only the first day, and halfway through the second, so it's all looking good.
How do you measure the success of an event such as this at a boat show?
It's simple. You just look at the numbers. So we look at the footfall. We look at the quality of people of the lead that we have, looking at either the power or the sailboat ranges that we represent here in Asia. And then we look at the information that we require, and then ultimately how many boats we sell from it. And at the moment, looking at the early stages of information, it's looking quite promising.
Now, you're country manager for Thailand for Simpson Marine.
That's correct.
How important is the Thai market to the company?
Oh, very. I mean, especially from the point of view that not only has Thailand been operating slightly more strongly, slightly more stronger than some countries in Asia. Also, it's in the heart of the charter area, and we're developing the charter business quite significantly within Simpson Marine, and certainly down in Phuket, our charter base in Thailand, our main charter base. We're seeing a large increase in bookings, and we're looking at ways of engaging that online via e-commerce, and also increasing the size of the fleet that we run.
Now, that's obviously a charter business where people are renting out the boats for a day or for a week and what have you. Who is actually taking the boats out on charter? Which markets are coming?
Well, as you just point out, I mean, there is a huge wealth of difference in charter. You can have day charters, which could be any number of tourists from different parts in the world. And then you also got the other end of the spectrum. You've got clients that might be flying from also anywhere in the world for maybe a week or two or even 3 weeks on something like a Lagoon sailing yacht. And the charter area that is offered from Phuket out into Pattaya Bay and down through the Andaman is really quite a wonderful area. So it's a very large different base of clientele that you see in the charter market, but it's growing all the time.
We're entering the high season in Thailand. Phuket traditionally, especially for the European markets, is very strong over the Christmas and New Year period. In terms of forward bookings for the charter business, what sort of things are we looking at?
Well, almost all booked out. So our fleet is almost all booked out. We're selling boats at the moment, and we've just sold another Lagoon this week, which we're putting into our charter fleet, and we're already looking at opening up that boat for bookings as we go into January. So yeah, it's a very busy time for charter, and we're looking at both power and sail, and all different sizes of boats, down from the Beneteau power range, for instance, that run day trips, up to anything like a super yacht such as a Sanlorenzo. So this is all available, and obviously the Lagoon obviously go up to this type of vessel as well, like the Lagoon 77. There are two of those operating in Asia, which are incredibly successful with charter.
In terms of sales here, who is buying boats here in Thailand, and what type of boats are they actually purchasing, and what sort of, because there's a lot of very rich young Thais here in that a lot of people don't realise, what are they looking for?
Yeah, you're quite right, there is, and actually we're starting to be able to engage with that market and speak to both people within the country and gain new clients that we didn't have before, and we're looking at also new initiatives, and I think that's something that's very important, is to be able to get the client of tomorrow. You have to be able to grow people into boating, and that's something we're trying to engage, and we're looking at different ways to approach this to try and get the younger age, so the age range from about 15 to 25, into boating from an early age and into smaller boats, and that's where most people start their hobby, and then that grows either via power or sail into a variety of different options.
When you say smaller boats, what do you mean, and how are you involved with that? Because this is something that we've been discussing for a long time, is how to get the young Thais out on the water.
If you speak to most sailors, and indeed people that have power boats, they will have started from a very small vessel. On the sailing side, most people have started in dinghies, learning, and that's very important in dinghies, because you only need to learn wind awareness. You get it wrong, then a little dinghy will go upside down. So it's a great way to get your wind awareness training up, and also it's a great way to get these younger people to get a passion for the sea. Once you have that passion for the sea, and these people then go to through to higher education and jobs, then they take the passion with them, and then therefore they grow their boating ownership aspirations with that.
Do you envisage, or do you foresee possibly, there are lots of races in this part of the world. There's the top of the Gulf Regatta here that takes place here at the Ocean Marina Yacht Club in Phuket, this Phuket Race Week. Could you envisage, or do you think it might be possible in the future that Simpson Marine could actually have their own team of boats racing in these type of events?
It's funny you should say that, actually. It's something I'm actually looking at the moment. I'm in discussions with a couple of yacht clubs around Thailand, and we're looking at trying to put a match fleet together. And via funds that might be available from different organisations, then if we can get a match fleet and a local race series going, then from that, as we've been speaking, you'll definitely grow the passion for the sea, which is what we need from within Thailand. So that's what will then happen naturally. The sport will progress from there.
What sort of boats would that be looking at for a match fleet?
So we represent Beneteau in Asia as well, and the Beneteau sailboats start with dinghies, actually. Start with what's called an F14, which is 14 foot long, and go up to then an 18, and then you move into a keel boat rather than a dinghy, which is the F24, and then the F27. We're thinking about maybe doing something with the F24s, or possibly even F27s, but the F24 is a really great boat to be able to get you close enough to the water to be able to learn the skills that you need, but also a big enough boat to give you the aspiration to want to grow your own interest within the sport.
Would you be concentrating these initiatives in Phuket, or where else in Thailand are you looking at?
Initially we'd be looking in Phuket, but you never say never. You know, there's such a wide variety of options within the Gulf of Thailand that would always be considered.
For the larger boats, today we're sat on one of your most prestigious boats. For the larger yachts, what is the market like here in terms of ultra luxury?
Oh, there's definitely a large market there that we are tapping, and indeed we have recently sold some larger yachts, super yachts, from Phuket. So there's definitely a market here in Pattaya. We're seeing inquiries increase, which is good over recent months. And we'll be developing that as the time goes on.
Now, of course, Sanlorenzo SL86 was the very first one in Asia, was handed to one of your clients in Phuket, I think just last month. Well, what is the Sanlorenzo SL86? What is it all about? What makes it special?
Oh, well, it's a step above. I mean, it's when you take luxury, and the real true word luxury, and then move it into boating. It's an experience which is higher, it's over and above anything that you will experience at sea anywhere else.
Now, in addition to that, recently I believe you've sold two Lagoon 67 catamarans, the very first in Asia, coming just after the Cannes premiere in September. One will be delivered to Taiwan in 2020 and then in Malaysia 2021. What is the Lagoon 67 catamaran? Why would it appeal to this market?
If you look
in Asia?
At the entire Lagoon range, what you'll see is the design that has gone into the platform of this type of catamaran, right from the 40 right up to the flagship 77. It's a truly remarkable boat which has been, it's been designed from the inside out, so every single bit of space has been used for something both practical and to provide a luxurious return for the client. And stepping aboard any boat, or the ones such as you mentioned, you will see that the level of luxury on board is just second to none.
How is technology changing sailing in this part of the world and elsewhere?
Well, I mean, technology is changing every day, as we know, and I could probably speak about how it's changing for hours and hours and hours and hours. But generally, what we're liking to see is the way that it's slowly, we're slowly seeing increases in both the digital side, so, you know, our navigation instrumentation, our Bluetooth capability, and the onboard Wi-Fi we have for certain systems to be able to talk to other systems, and indeed all the other equipment that's on board.
In terms of Thailand, what other events do you have planned over the next 12 months? Which events will you be attending here in Thailand?
Ultimately, the Thailand Yacht Show, which is coming up in January. So that will be a very large representation down in Phuket. And we're looking forward to representing all of the brands that we offer across Asia there. And there will be a large turnout from Simpson Marine to be able to show off what we represent.
Excellent. Well, Howard, I have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today. And of course, I wish you and Simpson Marine the best of luck for the future. Thank you.
Thank you very much.